Welcome students, today we are going to continue our lecture on unit 4 in PH8251 material science. Today's topic is dielectric breakdown mechanisms in dielectric materials. So let us define the dielectric breakdown first. So the breakdown in dielectrics means the physical deterioration or reduction of dielectric property due to the heavy current or heat. So when a heavy current or high heat is applied to a dielectric material, there is a phenomena called reduction of their dielectric nature. Such phenomena is defined as dielectric breakdown. So we all know that these dielectric materials are highly operational under various applied voltage. So to understand this breakdown mechanism in dielectric material, often we use the term called dielectric strength and breakdown voltage. When a voltage is applied to a dielectric and it is increased slowly, at a particular voltage there will be enormous current flow through the dielectric. That means at this particular applied voltage the material lost its insulating nature or non-conducting nature and started to conduct the electricity as normal conductor. Now we can say the material, the dielectric material is got breakdown, and this voltage, this critical voltage what we apply to the dielectric material when the dielectric breakdown occurs is called breakdown voltage. So we can define breakdown voltage is nothing but this is the applied voltage level where a dielectric material suffers dielectric breakdown. So this breakdown voltage is highly depends on the material's thickness. Depending on the thickness of the material to material, the voltage required to achieve this breakdown may get varied. So based on this we can calculate the second technical important parameter called dielectric strength. So the dielectric strength is nothing but it is the ratio between breakdown voltage and thickness of the dielectric material used for the application. There are five distinct process which will results the breakdown in dielectrics. They are number one, intrinsic breakdown, number two, thermal breakdown, number three, discharge breakdown, number four, electrochemical breakdown, number five, defect breakdown. Let us see one by one elaborately. First type of breakdown is called intrinsic breakdown. In general, the insulating nature of the dielectric may be affected by the application of large current across the dielectric material as we told earlier. In the presence of some impurity atoms present in the material, there is a possibility of reduction of insulating nature in such dielectrics. Much before our expectation. How this transportation occurs in insulators? We all know that when we discussing about the difference between conductor, semiconductor and insulator, on the basis of band theory, we are giving two distinct bands, namely valence band and conduction band. We all know that all the electrons in an insulator are highly bounded in valence electron, and the conduction are bounded in valence band, and conduction band seems to be empty. When an electron in the valence band jumps to conduction band, that electron becomes free electron and they will be free to move through the conduction band. By the way, that will helps the conduction of electricity in the material. Such electron is called free electrons. So the energy difference between the topmost energy level of the valence band and the lowest energy level of the conduction band is considered to be band gap. So when the subsequent amount of energy is supplied to the material to overcome this band gap between the valence band and conduction band, an electron in the valence band maybe jumps to conduction band and constitute the electricity in the material. As we know, in the case of dielectrics or insulators, the band gap between the valence band and conduction band is very large. So it is not possible to transfer an electron from valence band to conduction band in normal circumstances. That's why the insulators are not able to produce substantial conduction of electricity. But when we apply the large amount of current through these dielectrics, there may be a possibility of an electron to jump from valence band to conduction band. So thus will initiate the flow of current or leakage of current through the dielectric material. In this scenario, the material started to conduct. So this is called intrinsic breakdown, since the insulating nature of the material is reduced by the applied electric field. And if some impurities are present in the material, that impurity will aid this transfer of electron from valence band to conduction band. By the way, it will increases the flow of this leakage current. By the way, you can able to see the conduction through insulators or dielectrics. This phenomenon is called intrinsic breakdown. In such cases, if the transferred electron from valence band to conduction band, if it triggers other electron to make a transition from valence band to conduction band, by the way, that will result larger amount of electron to move from valence band to conduction band as a chain reaction, that will result large amount of current to flow through the material. This phenomena of production of last flow of current through the dielectric material is called as avalanche breakdown. So let us see the characteristics of this intrinsic breakdown. So we can say this kind of breakdowns will occur at high voltage, and this can occur even at low temperature also, and again this will more often happen in thin samples of dielectrics only. The next type of breakdown is thermal breakdown. The thermal breakdown is nothing but it is the dielectric breakdown that occurs due to the excess heat in the material. So we all know that when a electric energy is transferred through the dielectric material, in the each cycle of the material there will be the production of heat energy due to the loss phenomena. If such heat is generated in the dielectric materials, this heat should be dissipated throughout the materials very quickly. But due to the non-conducting nature of the dielectric materials, This generated heat will not be dissipated through the material that much force as it is created. So there will be larger amount of heat accumulation in a particular part that will create the breakdown in the material and causes the conduction of electricity much easily in these materials. So this kind of breakdown, which is caused due to the higher amount of heat which is accumulated in the dielectric material, is called thermal breakdown. The characteristics are, this can occur only at high temperatures. So it totally depends on size and shape, and this loss also directly proportional to the high frequency and also nature of the applied electric field, whether it is a direct field or alternating field. So for alternating field, the breakdown will be less in the case of alternating field, and it will be very large in the case of direct field. Third type of breakdown is called discharge breakdown. The dielectric breakdown that occur due to gas discharge phenomena in the accumulated gas bubbles inside the material, which is formed during the manufacturing of the material, is known as discharge breakdown. So we all know that when a high voltage is applied in such gas bubbles in the material, thus these gas bubbles will get ionized, results the gas to collide with the solid atoms and produces free electrons. These free electrons may lead to increase of current flow, and this is the result of dielectric breakdown, and this phenomena is called discharge breakdown. So this can occur at low voltages where large number of accumulated gas bubbles are present in the system. When discharge takes place at a point, the surrounding places get burned, and hence their electrical property are affected. So if there are large number of accumulated gas bubbles, that will result large number of discharge inside the material. Hence the material will get damaged easily. Hence this kind of breakdown depends on number of discharges. So we can say it depends on the frequency of the electric field we are using and the applied voltage. Next type of breakdown is electrochemical breakdown. The dielectric breakdown that resulting due to the electrochemical reactions that occur in dielectrics due to the increased mobility of ions at high temperature, which results in leakage of current. This phenomena is called electrochemical breakdown. So we all know that in a system of ionic crystals, when we apply high temperature, that will make the mobility of ions in the material, though this mobility of ions will result in higher possibility for chemical reactions. These chemical reactions will result in the higher amount of electricity passed through the material. By the way, the material will lose its insulating nature in certain point of time, then there is the breakdown of dielectric nature. So these breakdown mechanisms depends on amount of leakage current produced, density of ions, temperature and permanent dipole moment of the material. If the impurities are added with the pure insulator, this will increase the possibility of more electrochemical reactions. And these electrochemical reactions also highly dependable on the temperature. At high temperature, there will be more possibility for electrochemical reactions. Next type of breakdown is defect breakdown. So, if a dielectric breakdown which may be caused by the defects such as cracks and bores, impurities such as moistures or dust, then this type of breakdown is called as defect breakdown. So these are all five important mechanisms of breakdowns. So to avoid this breakdown, when we choose a dielectric material or insulator, we need to have very good control on their properties, and we have to choose proper material for the required applications. So, in order to identify the proper insulator, following are the important properties of insulator that should be carefully chosen to avoid such breakdown mechanisms. Number one, the dielectric materials should have, or insulators should have, high dielectric strength that will results you higher breakdown voltage, so it will helps the material to withstand up to high voltage. Next, the high mechanical strength, it will helps you in machining, and it will help you in avoiding defects or damages to the material. Next is, the material should have high fire resistance, then it should be highly chemical inertness, and it should have high thermal conductivity so that you can avoid the thermal breakdown. And the material should have low dielectric loss. They should be low in thermal expansion, and they should have low water absorption quality. So these are all the important properties of insulator. So we can see different type of insulators and dielectrics in our day-to-day life. Now we can see what are all the applications based on their goal. So there will general, we are using this dielectric material for two major applications. One is as a capacitor to store electrical energy. Next is in transformers as a insulator and coolant. In capacitors, as I told you, the capacitor finds application as store electrical energy. So different types of dielectrics are used in different types of capacitor, which is used in different areas. First, the capacitor which use vacuum, air and gas as dielectrics are used in radio frequency circuits and low frequency measuring circuits. The capacitor which use mineral oils, the liquid form of dielectrics, as are used in high voltage applications where the large value of capacitance is required. Capacitors which use a combination of solid and liquid dielectrics are used for power factor corrections in electrical power distribution systems. And solid dielectrics are used in laboratory and many electronic circuitry as a standard capacitors. We are often see these capacitors in our all the electronic devices. The next major area of application of these dielectric materials in transformers In transformers, the dielectrics are used both as a coolant as well as an insulator. The nitrogen gas is a good example of gas form of dielectrics which is used in transformers because it is chemically inert. In oil field transformers, it is used to replace oxidation atmosphere. Transformer oil is a type of mineral insulating oil or a synthetic oil. It is used for insulation and cooling of transformers. It is also maintains the insulation of the windings. Sulfur hexafluoride is used as a superior coolant in transformers. It has high dielectric strength and non-inflammable nature. Cotton tape is also used as an insulator in oil field transformers, and the borosilanes, which is used in our high voltage power line transformations as a transformers as a insulators and safety connectors. So these are all the some major applications of dielectric materials, and dielectric material applications are not restricted these things. You can see so many such applications in our regular data.